Guys, in the news lately, a lot about your credit score as it relates to potential security breaches. Equifax, that was a big one. And that continues to happen as people try to steal your identity. But beyond just the pain it could be to get it all straightened out, it also could impact you buying a house or even maybe selling a house. Jessica Luthor from Coldwell Banker joins us this morning. Good morning. So let's talk about how this breach could actually have an impact on you.
Right. Well, especially if you are going to buy a home.
Right.
So if you're going to pay cash, then it may not be as big of a problem. But if you are like the vast majority of home buyers, you're going to be taking out a mortgage to buy this new house. And when you take out a mortgage, your lender is going to scrutinize your credit. I mean, they're going
more so than it used to be, right? Before the crash, it used to be almost anybody could buy a house, and now they really take a hard look, don't they?
Well, terms were a little looser.
Okay.
Yeah. So they've tightened up on that a little bit. So they are going to be looking at, especially your debt to income ratio. So if you look at, if someone has taken your identity and opened a credit card and run up that balance, and that throws off your debt to income ratio, now you may not qualify for a loan that you did before.
Because they're looking at your ability to pay it back based on what you make.
Right, and how much debt you have.
Right.
You know, how much you make, but how much of that is already obligated in other places. So now you're under contract on a house, and you no longer qualify for your loan.
Right.
You've got to get this cleared up. So sellers aren't necessarily just going to sit there and wait, you know, indefinitely for you to get this fixed so you can eventually buy their house. So better to get this addressed ahead of time.
What are some things you can do to try to minimize your exposure potentially?
Well, I mean, first of all, pull your credit report yourself. You can do that once a year for free.
Okay.
So, and I think a lot of people know that you can pull your credit report for free annually, but they're not actually doing it. So you really want to buy a house? Really do it.
Okay.
Pull your credit report so that you've got your first eyes on that and you can see, oh, wait, that's not me, and fix that ahead of time before you're stuck potentially losing the house.
Right.
So beyond that, you can put a freeze on your credit.
Tell me what that is.
Okay, so a freeze, this is the most extreme, but it's also the most effective. So no one then can open an account in your name. You've got to unfreeze it to be able to. So you can freeze your credit and still try to buy a house, but you will have to then unfreeze it to do that mortgage app.
So basically, if you're kind of just going through life and you've got your credit cards and you've got your mortgage, you've got your car you're going to keep for a little while, you can just do that so nobody can get your credit, period. So no one, if they try to steal your credit, you go, nope, sorry, you're shut down.
Shut down. Yep. You would have to unfreeze it so that they could pull your credit.
Does freezing have a negative impact on your credit?
It does not. That's a myth. We haven't done myths in a while. That's a myth. People do think that it does. It doesn't. It just makes it very difficult then to pull your credit.
So if you're living a regular life, and even if you're thinking next year I'm going to buy a house, it might be a good idea, especially with these potential breaches out.
Right. Or you can just do the fraud alert. A fraud alert doesn't freeze it necessarily, but no one can take out that credit without your permission. Right. So not as extreme, but still
real helpful. Quick question, who do you get in contact with to freeze your credit?
So this is ironic. Equifax is one.
Thanks, guys.
That's one option. Experian and TransUnion.
Okay, all three of the biggest.
Exactly.
Okay, I love it.
Exactly.
Jessica Luthor, Coldwell Banker Realty, appreciate you coming in. If you're going to buy a house, you certainly want to make sure your money is in your pocket, not someone else's, right? Thanks for joining us today. We'll put links for it at abccolumbia.com.